Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I have a fun event. This is part of a blog hop celebrating the latest release markers by Altenew. There is lots of inspiration along the blog hop and lots of giveaways, so make sure to visit my blog and join the fun. Altenew has released two new sets of alcohol markers, so set B and set C, since there is already set A that we have been using for about a year now. I am going to show you all the colors today and then I'm going to create a card just to see how they work together. Now I'm going to open them up so you can see what's included. So in each one of the boxes you get 12 different colors, and actually they are made in a set because four of them always match in between them, so you can easily blend them. And here is the first set that has been released a while back. So in the first set we got reds, blues and greens, so the next two sets are here to complete some of the gaps, so since we didn't have purples or we didn't have yellows, etc. So let's take a closer look on the marker. So there are two nibs, and on both the caps you get the number of the marker, and there is also the number on the barrel. On the barrel you will find a grey ring that will help you tell which nib is which. So here are the two nibs that you get. One is a fine bullet nib and the other one is a brush. And if you try this marker, you are going to love the brush. It's very soft and you can do lots of techniques. And they are really the best alternative to Copic, since not other alcohol markers in the market do have that beautiful brush. Plus they are cheaper, so if you want to start an alcohol marker collection, I would definitely suggest to get one set. You will try it out and you will love it. Now this is where you can see the number on the barrel, so no matter what you do, you will never mix up the caps with other markers, with other barrels. Now the barrel, as you can see, has a triangular shape, so it doesn't roll on your table. Now there are three different sets, 12 markers in each set, so 36 in total. I'm going to swatch them for you so you can see everything that you get in a set, and I started with set B. In this set you will get purples, yellows and greys, all the way from lighter to darker shade that you can mix and match together. So there is no guessing here, you just get a set and everything you need to blend them nicely together is inside. So here are the grey shades, and these are the colors that you get in set B. Now I'm going to swatch for you set C. So they start with four shades of red, for all the way from lighter to darker, and there are reds in the first set, which I'm going to show you later on. These are the blue shades included in set C, again from lighter to darker, and there are even more blue shades on set A. I'm going to show them later on to you. And finally there are the four scoops. These are four markers that they give you a beautiful color combination, and you can blend them with other markers if you wish. So you will get Peach Perfect, Mango Smoothie, Cotton Candy and Dark Chocolate. And since I did set B and C that have just been released, I am going to do set A for you so you can see the differences. As I said, you will get here your reds, greens and blues, but there are no duplicates with the rest of the sets. So these are the reds just underneath the set C, and you can see that there are no duplicates. You can beautifully blend the colors in each set, but you can definitely mix and match them. Just because some colors are in one set, it doesn't mean that you cannot blend them with other sets. So now let's move on to the blues, and you can definitely see that they are totally different shades of blue than set C. And finally the greens, from lighter middle green to darker green, and the fourth is not a super dark green, it's a black one. So if you want the black marker, you will find it in set A. So these are all the colors that have been released up to now. I really love these markers, they have a great nib, Plus, they make a perfect match with their Altenew inks. So these are the ovals sets where you get four colors all the way from lighter to darker. And these are great when you do layering stamping. And you will find that these match perfectly with the blues that I'm going to show you. So they were deliberately made like that. And there are available charts online on their website that you can print, that you can download and print them out. And these will definitely going to show you which marker matches perfectly with which of the inks. So for example, the blush ink is R400 and it goes on like that. And now let's have some fun creating a card and playing with the markers. For my card, I will be using the Altenew Lotus stamp set, and there are also matching dies. I'm going to stamp with black alcohol-friendly ink some of those flowers, and then I'm going to color them in. For coloring my Lotus, I decided to go with light red or pink. I am starting with the darker color at the bottom of each petal, and I'm going to gradually go to middle color and then to the lighter one. I'm not going to color the whole petal all the way to the tip, as I always like to have a bit of highlight at the end by leaving that white. So I'm going to repeat the same process, and you can see how beautifully they blend together. Again, I'm starting with a darker color. I'm going to move on to the middle color. And then I'm going to move on to the lighter one and just touch it a little bit at the edges. And also notice that I'm working on each petal separately. It's always easier to blend alcohol markers when the ink isn't dry on your paper. And that's why I'm not doing all the darker shades in every petal and then go back to the middle color, etc. So I like to work on each area and then move on to a next one. Also, there are even more techniques to work with your alcohol markers. So, for example, you can start with a lighter color and then go to the middle, to the darker, and then all the way back to the lighter one. Now, for this particular project, I didn't want to oversaturate my flowers, and that's why I'm working with this technique where I'm only touching each of the three markers once. So I'm not blending too much, and although I'm not working on each petal a lot of time, you see that they blend beautifully together. You don't have to go over the markers again and again. And again, using the same technique, I'm going to go ahead and color the rest of the flowers, again petal by petal, and from darker to lighter. Now I have finished coloring all my images, and I am going to use the matching dies to cut them out. So I am separating them, and then I'm going to place them on top of my images and secure them down with some post-it tape, and then run them through my Big Shot. Now all my images are ready to go, so it's time to start assembling my card. For my card base, I'm going to use this cardstock. This is also by Altenew. It's their Forest Glades color, and it matches perfectly with the rings and of course their markers. That makes it really foolproof. So now I have cut it out in half. I'm going to create a side folding card, And I have a white panel where I will do all the assembling that is slightly smaller than the standard card. So I will end up having that beautiful green border around it. Now I have my stamping platform, and after playing around a little bit with the flowers, trying to decide how my flower composition is going to be, now I can add the stamps on top so that I can stamp the stems. And again, I'm using black ink, and that's actually Memento Tuxedo black ink. This is alcohol marker friendly, and I will be able to color in the stems later on without any smudges or smears. Now this area is so tiny that is a great thing to have that fine tip nib on one side of my marker, since I can guarantee you that if I used that brass nib, I would definitely go outside the lines. Now it is time to start assembling my card. I am adding some tape adhesive at the back of the flowers, so I'm going to stick that directly on top of my card. And for the third flower, I'm going to add a couple of foam squares at the back, and these are going to help this flower pop on top of my card, and it's going to give some dimension. Now here is where I decided to stamp one more stem at the bottom there, so that I can stick on top my big leaf. I'm also going to color it in with the thin tip of my marker, and then I'm going to apply some tape adhesive at the back of this huge leaf. And I really love that touch of green at the bottom of my card. And I'm going to add the rest of the leaves and complete my composition. Now this design is very versatile. It can easily be a birthday card, a hello card, a thank you card, anything you really want. I decided to go with a big and bold sentiment that says hello, and this is from the envelope liner die, and I just love that handwritten font. Now I'm going to add some white glue at the back and then stick it on top of my card. Now I'm going to stick this panel on top of my card base, and I just added some tape adhesive at the back. And then I'm going to finish off my card by adding some shine with my Nuvo drops. So I'm going to add a couple of drops at the center of the flowers and a few clear ones all over the card. So that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. If you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to visit my blog, because you will find all the info there for lots of giveaways. Thank you all so much for watching, and see you next time.